Today we are going to learn Chapter 5 Arithmetic Progression of CBSE textbook. Arithmetic progression means it's a number sequence. So we can see number sequence here 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. It's an infinite number sequence, but we usually take finite number sequence. So 2, 4, 6, 8, we can see the consecutive terms differ by 2, which we take as D. 4 minus 2, 6 minus 4, 8 minus 6, everything equal to 2. That means in an arithmetic progression, the number sequences have their common difference, which we denote by D. D will be same throughout the number sequence. Another example, 5, 10, 15, etc. So there also we can see the common difference between the two consecutive terms. We have 5, where A1 is the first term, which we always denote by A. A2 is the second term, which we get by adding A with common difference. For example, 2 plus 2 is 4. Similarly, third term, A3. A3 we get by adding first term plus two common differences. That is A plus D plus D. So we don't denote it as A plus 2D. And A4 will be similarly A plus D plus D plus D. That means A added with 3 times of D. So A plus 3D. Going ahead like this, we can write AN as A plus D plus D plus D plus etc. D will be added N minus 1 times. So the nth term of an AP with common difference D and first term A is A plus N minus 1 times D, or we write the formula AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So for an AP with N terms, A1, A2, A3, etc. AN, the last term we find by taking the formula AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, where A is the first term and D is the common difference. N is the number of terms. AN will be the last term. So we can see that for an arithmetic progression with terms A1, A2, A3, etc. AN, A1, which is represented as first term as A, and common difference D, AN last term, the formula is AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. First term plus N minus 1 times D is added to get AN. Okay, that's it.